world of innovation. I hope it's not lost on you that actually we're actually in the new armories here in the sort of Tower of London. And what we hope to do today is actually arm the industry with new weapons and new tools to make beef and lamb in particular relevant to the modern consumer.
Sort of the individual cuts we have been working on. I can't show you them all because our portfolio on beef and lamb and pork, which we have in our meat purchasing guide, contain about 600 cuts, and we already have more than probably 30 to go in the next version of the meat purchasing guide. And if we add these up, and these are just a couple of examples, you know, and we haven't gone through the whole process, but this would add this amount of money to it.
And the moral of the story in that is each muscle performs unique. So that Denver cut, it actually doesn't age out until 21 days, where the chuck eye ages out at 14 days. You've hit your maximum tenderness. And so knowing those unique differences, we can start to match. Now, I just want you guys to see that this isn't consumer facing, right? The changes in the industry force us to innovate, and then we have to go try to educate the consumers. So realize that what we have found in the United States is the consumer acceptance of this, if I put it in a retailer and I don't tell them about it, it fails. We have to make things easy and taste good. But how we do retail, convenient, fresh product is critical. The websites continue to be key, and social media is where they're finding that information. And that's what you see on this. Is food itself the trend? And if food is fashion, and food is art, and food is trend, then that opens new doors for how we market it. We can stay kind of butchery and meat and tradition, or we can become relevant and fun and flavorful.
There are a few steaks, but they don't know how to go beyond that, about stewing and braising and roasting and taking some of those lesser value cuts and moving them forward. Some of the things that we've done are working to make cooking beef more convenient, making it faster for consumers, making it a lot quicker for consumers. So we've done two different projects as of right now. We're working on another one. You have to have the right muscle. You have to have a fat cap on it. You have to have the right bag. You have to have the right cooking times. You have to have the right seasoning. All that has to be in play to come together to produce this product. The three-in-one starter kits. The idea behind a three-in-one starter kit is taking fresh beef, okay, adding the seasoning packet to that fresh beef and merchandising that way. But as Mike talked about earlier, it's 3-in-1, and you give the consumer three different options with that label, with that product. Can we make it more convenient? I think we can. And so we're introducing slow cooker roast. And really what this is a chuck roast or an arm roast cooked in a special bag in the slow cooker. Consider this cut. With this packaging and this preparation method, this packaging, you put it in the crock pot, cause you to buy it more often? 100% of consumers said yes. To improve is to change. To be perfect is to change off.
We've seen a massive growth in casual dining in the UK. And casual dining as opposed to quick service. And the next big market is this family market. And what we're seeing is casual dining is all about families. It's all about very keen midweek marketing. Lots of brands, lots of offers midweek. And most importantly, they're spending their money on educating the front of house staff. And with passion, it's all about value. It's not about cheap. You get that consistency of cuts. And the great thing is there's much, 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 much more lamb appearing on every menu. Every place we went to last night, there was lamb on the menu. Lamb, lamb, lamb. But interestingly, not the traditional cuts. It wasn't just pulled lamb. There were so many different ways of serving lamb. It's being famous for what you do best. You know, we've often said, you know, better do one thing really well than do 10 things badly. The simpler the menu, the more effective it will be.